it isn't the bitch in the red dress.
Hello and welcome to my first ever complete walkthrough in English. Yeah, whether you like it or not. We are going to play Resident Evil 4, the Wii edition. But we're not going to play the main game with Leon. We are going to play Separate Ways. Yeah, the side mission with Ada Wong. Oh, where you can play as Ada Wong. Okay, what we're doing here. Yeah, so Separate Ways is the name of the game, and yeah, I'll just say let's get started right away. Here we go. Yeah, it's also known in Japan as Another Order, or yeah, in Japan pretty much Resident Evil is known as Biohazard. But anyway, as you can see, I still have German subtitles, so you can read the majority of the story
for yourself. I'll have to reveal myself to him and offer advice once in a while.
Yeah. So, what's the plan of this game? Yeah, we're playing as Ada Wong. We are working for none other than the much hated Albert Wesker himself. Yeah, I can't tell you how much I hate this guy. Yeah, we're still in Spain. We pretty much travel through the whole game on Ada's perspective. But it's much shorter than the normal game. I think when you play the normal game, your first playthrough should take about 12 to 15 hours. I think that's average time for a first playthrough. Separate Ways is much shorter. It only has 5 chapters. And well, as you have notice, there are no selectable difficulty levels, so we just have a normal mode, or maybe it is a hard mode, I don't know. there is just this one difficulty level.
So I see, and yeah,
here we got the man with the plan and the sunglasses.
Yes, but nobody remembered to roll out my red carpet.
Oh, too bad.
The villagers there are all being controlled. They automatically attack any intruders. Ring the church bell. That should quiet them down for a while.
Sounds like they're good, obedient boys and girls.
Unfortunately, time is not a luxury we have. Gather as much information as you can about the parasites and finish off this little tour.
That's Leo.
Leo.
And she probably still has a crush on him. But okay, this is our first order. We have to ring the church bell, as Mr. Blondie says. Yeah, here we have our map. It's a pretty short trip and a pretty short chapter too, just to get used to the controls and so on. But they haven't changed from the normal game, or the main game, as you would like to call it. That's up to you. Yo. We still have to shoot villagers, which are infected by a parasite, of course. And we still have to survive. And we also hear some noises in the background from Leon. Since the events of the normal game and this mission happen at the same time, we will sometimes will come across some pretty weird situations. Whoa! What the hell was that? Running towards me without a head, but okay. Yeah, collect some ammo and money, of course. We will need the money definitely later on. And you definitely have noticed this crosshair. And yeah, we're playing the Wii edition, as I said before. With thanks to the Wii mode, and then yeah, pretty much thanks to the Wii mode, god damn it, we can aim much more precisely. It's definitely way better than aim with a normal controller and yeah, some filthy food. Filthy. Yeah, there is a gun. We better Ada decides to leave that for Leon since we already have a shotgun to begin with. But we have a shotgun, but we still can buy other weapons from the famous, or let's say infamous, merchant, which is also back in this side story in separate ways. Okay. Familiar cutscene. Oh god, it's the chainsaw guy. Yeah. But he won't show up. you see him in the cutscene, but he won't show up here. You will just hear some chainsaw noises and some yelling from Leon, but actually he isn't out there. He's at some place with Leon. I don't know where, and I really don't want to know. Since chainsaws can be pretty dangerous. But yeah, you're pretty much asking what we're doing here anyway. We have to wait for a certain cutscene so we can find the key and enter the house on the left, where we started, with the house with these insignias on the door, and we need a key to open it. And yeah, that's the key. Now we have to get to the roof, and Ada has a pretty useful toy with her. And no, I don't mean what you might have think or thought now. She has a hook shot. It's pretty useful. You can you can climb on roofs or climb over other obstacles, which Leon was not able to reach or climb up. Ah, shit, he got me. Nice shot. Yeah, when I first played this game, I I was scared sometimes that the man with the chainsaw could show up from anywhere. I don't know. And since one contact with the chainsaw is an instant death, it's it's pretty annoying, this guy. I don't like it. So, oh, shut up. Whoops. Okay, I think we should leave now. Or okay, let's check out the other cabins for some items. Maybe we can find a treasure on the way. Climb up the ladder, up the tower, and hope we can find something useful here. Like shotgun shells. Oh, there was some way down. And she didn't even hurt herself. Twisted her ankle or whatever the hell I know. Anyway, let's use the key and get away from here. And in this house we should meet. Yeah, there he is. It's the merchant. And as you probably know, kill the snake, take the egg, and some ammo. As you probably know, he has something to say.
Welcome.
And something even more important.
Your selection of good things on sale, stranger.
Yeah. Same old story. We can sell him treasures and can buy weapons from him. Unfortunately, it's not possible to upgrade weapons in separate ways. We can only buy buy stuff, weapons, first aid spray, and so on. But we can upgrade ammo capacity or stopping power from any kind of weapons. But okay, we have to deal with it, and that's it. Pretty much it. What's that? Hey! Where did they come from? Okay, they pretty much sneaked past the merchant. The merchant didn't stop them. I guess the only thing to get his attention is probably money. And I don't know, is he a friend or not? I guess we'll never know. It's the same story. We will probably never know why he always is one step ahead of Ada or Leon. Or he has like 10 million clone brothers. I have no idea. But it's just a video game. It's just imagination. Okay. Whoa! There is a torch clipping through a door. And I really like these men and women. Let's switch to the shotgun. I really like these men and women with the torches, because sometimes they will ignite themselves, which is pretty useful. It's like you're throwing a fire grenade. Oh, come on, ignite yourself. Yeah! That takes care of the cremation, I might add. Grab some money and still alive. Didn't got any goodies for me. Didn't have. But okay. Fine with me. More of them. Okay, I think we should be at the cemetery right now, and the church isn't too far away either. Youch. Nice and easy. Always aim for the head. Okay. Should be. I'll just walk between them, turn back, and take these idiots out. Probably a good time to switch to the shotgun. Youch! Stupid asshole. Okay, handgun ammo, add some money. Nice shot. Switch back and forth, yeah. Yeah, it would be much more helpful if they had a quick selection with the D-pad, like in Resident Evil 5. But okay, we have to deal with it this way. Okay, let's check out this cabin and grab some ammo. What we got here? Oh, a yellow herb! Yeah, like in all Resident Evil games, we can mix herbs. There is of course the green herb, the red one you can combine, and there is a new one, the yellow herb, which will extend the life meter. Okay, what we have to do now is check out these tombstones, and we collected a red gem, and we have to memorize the symbols on these tombstones, gravestones. Let's just say grave. So we have this Z, the M, and this V icon. It's probably the best way to memorize them. Okay, where is he coming from? Show yourself. There he is. Nice one. I still can't get used to that. How in